Hello, welcome to the Software Application Development and Deployment using the AMD Embedded Development Framework, EDF, how-to video. In this video, we will cover the SDK-based development flow targeting AMD Versal Adaptive SoCs. We will begin by installing the AMD EDF SDK. Then, a simple Hello World application and kernel will be developed and compiled on an x86 host PC and deployed directly onto a Versal AI Edge Series Gen 2 VEK385 evaluation board. The quick emulator QEMU flow for application deployment will also be explored to showcase its functionality. A software development kit SDK for cross-development on an x86 host is useful when a user does not have access to a board for on-target development. This SDK can be downloaded as a shell script, which is part of the EDF. Note that you can create your SDK as well using the AMD EDF. Depending on the project, the SDK can actually speed up the build task compared to building on target. The downside is that the content of the SDK is fixed and it is not possible to install additional development packages or utilities into an existing SDK, but customers can recreate the SDK from EDF when needed, so that it's in sync. On-target development, however, allows packages to be installed from the package feed. This video assumes that the Versal evaluation kit has already been set up to boot into the AMD EDF Linux environment. Refer to the Getting Started with AMD EDF video for more information on these steps. Download the EDF application and machine SDK, install script from the EDF downloads, wiki page linked below. Download the QEMU pre-built artifacts if you would like to explore deploying applications to an emulated system. If you are planning to follow along and deploy the example application to the board itself, ensure that there is a network connection between the host PC and the board via the PS Ethernet port. This can be done directly or over a local network. Note that running the applications on the board will also require serial communication over the FTD-IUSB-C port. The software development flow demonstrated in this video is also available in text form in the Software Application Development wiki page. To use the EDF SDK, it must first be installed on your host machine. Download the EDF application and machine SDK install script from the AMD EDF wiki page. Note that the downloaded SDK script needs to be made executable so it can be run. To allow executable access, run chmod plus x, the SDK file name, .sh. Next, to install the SDK, execute the shell script file by running .slash, the SDK file name, .sh. The script will ask the desired install location for the SDK. Make sure to choose a location on the system where you have write permissions. In this example, /home/AMD/EDF is used as the install location. After successfully installing the SDK, set up the development environment variables by running source path to SDK /environment-device. Here, the path is the one that was previously created at /home/AMD/EDF. After an SDK is installed to a specific location, it cannot be simply moved. It has been set up to work from that specific location. If you wish to move the SDK to a different location, rerun the installation script specifying the new location. Now let's clone, build, and install an example application to test the newly set up SDK. Run wget on this link to the Hello World application on gnu.org. This will download the necessary files to build and run the application. Once completed, extract the archive by using the tar-xf command and the archive name. CD into the extracted archive. Run ./configure to set up the makefile for your environment. Note that --host equals arch64 is passed to the configure script to indicate that we are cross-compiling for the ARM architecture. to generate the executable file, run the make command with argument-j, followed by number of CPU cores. Run the file command on the generated hello-elf file. Note that this binary is generated for the ARM architecture, found in the Versal processing system, PS. The resulting binary file can then be copied over to the evaluation board and run to ensure proper setup and deployment. To do this, ensure that you have a valid connection between the host and the evaluation board through the board's PS Ethernet. Then, use SCP to copy the executable file from the SDK into the board's directory with the board's IP address. After that, switch over to the evaluation board's embedded command line serial interface by connecting your PC to the lowest COM port from the board using a terminal emulator like PuTTY. Navigate to the directory that the executable file was copied to and make sure it has proper permissions by running chmod plus xhello. Now all that is left is to run .hello to execute the file and to run your application. It should output hello world. Kernel modules similarly can be developed and compiled on a host PC. In this demo, an HDMI kernel module will be built and deployed to a Versal evaluation board. This example is for illustration only. The compiled kernel module is not used subsequently. If you are building your own kernel module, the same steps apply, provided your kernel module source tree and make file follow the same structure as this example. First, make sure the SDK is sourced in the environment by running source, path to SDK. Here the path is the one that was previously created at /home/AMD/EDF. The kernel must be prepared for this. To do so, begin by setting the kernel source directory environment variable. Next, inside that directory, set the local version variable to create a unique identifier for the kernel in use. To get the ID for the kernel being built, run make kernel release. Last, run make modules prepare to ensure all necessary parts of the kernel are generated and the kernel is fully prepared. Now, the HDMI 2.1 modules, Xilinx GitHub repository, can be cloned on the host PC using git clone at github.com/Xilinx/HDMI 2.1 modules. CD into the cloned repository and run the make command with the -j argument, followed by number of CPU cores on the host PC. Use ls to list the generated kernel module file in the xfmc directory of the repo. This module can be copied into the kernel module directory of the active kernel on the evaluation board. This can be done via SCP with an established network connection to the board. Use a terminal emulator to connect to the lowest COM port provided by the board using a terminal emulator like PuTTY. Ensure that the kernel file was successfully copied onto the board. Create an XFMC directory under the updates folder of the current kernel module. Move the generated .ko file to this new XFMC directory. Run sudo depmod to check all dependencies and associated map files. Finally, run mod info with the name of our kernel module, HDMI2.1-XFMC, to view the module properties. The SDK also provides QEMU scripts for full system emulation. Source the SDK environment script. Extract the QEMU artifacts, tar file for your evaluation kit, and CD into the new directory. Note how booting QEMU requires essentially the same boot artifacts and disk image used to boot on hardware. In this directory, run the command run QEMU combined .qemuboot.conf no graphic slurp to launch all required QEMU instances. This process may take some time. The result will be a Linux login prompt. Use the default username AMD-EDF and create a password. This environment is a full system emulation of the VEK385 board with OSPI plus UFS boot mode. Thus, the Hello World application generated earlier can be executed here. Transfer the HelloElf file from the host to the QEMU session. This can be done using SCP. Ensure that Hello has executable permissions and run the application. The output is the same as when we ran it on hardware. Here's a quick summary of what you learned from this video. First, the AMD EDF application and machine SDK was installed simply by running the installer script featured on the EDF Downloads wiki page. This SDK was used to cross-compile applications for ARM cores using an x86 host PC. This compiled application was then deployed to AMD Versal AI Edge Series Gen 2 VEK385 evaluation board and executed. We then covered building kernel modules on the x86 host PC and deployed a module to the evaluation board. Finally, we showed how a Hello World application can be deployed to a full Versal system emulated by QEMU.